I'm you just sitting there, but you're enjoying hanging with somebody. Lord God Almighty, we give you the praise and the thank for one more day, one more time. Thank you for God and goodness and mercy. Lord of Lord, he clipped lips clean that we may be able to speak today in the word of God. Have your divine way in this service around the world. Bless now, Lord. Bless now, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lift those hands up and say, thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. The Lord is good. The Lord is good. Well, maybe he ain't good to nobody but me, but the Lord is good to me. Amen. Amen. I said, the Lord is good to me. Amen. Take it, amen. Form out if you have a cell phone and text, amen, about three people to tell them this is your servant day. They just might get a blessing. Who knows? Can you say amen? For the Lord is good. Amen. Good to see you today. Are you glad to be here?
Amen.
Our God that we serve is a big God. That's all I can say. He's a big God. Huh? The psalmist said, great is the Lord, and he's worthy to be praised. Great is the Lord, and he's worthy to be praised. Amen. Praise God. Amen. In the book of Jude, if you have your Bible, will you turn? Amen. Very first verse, amen, the book of Jude. Amen. Jude, the servant of Jesus Christ and brother of James, to them that are sanctified by God the Father and the Lord in Christ Jesus and come. Sanctified, preserved, and we're kept. Mercy unto you and peace and love be multiplied. Beloved, I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation. It was needful for me to write unto you and exalt you as you understand. Ten for the faith which was delivered to saints. Amen. 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 Did you hear that one? I contend for the faith that was delivered to saints. Amen. Now what did you do with that faith? He gave it to you. He delivered it to you. The word deliver means that somebody gave you something. He delivered to you. Amen. I'm going to the book of Romans, amen. Then I'll just see you. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. I tell you, the Lord loves just me. In the 12th chapter of the book of Romans, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God. Amen. And he present your body a living sacrifice, holy, accepted unto God, which is your reasonable service. Be not conformed to this world, but be renewed by the glory of God, renewing of your mind, that may prove that which is good and accepted and the perfect will of God. For I said, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more higher than he ought to think, but to think so. So, call that glory to God. Think so. Amen. Call that God has dealt to every man the measure of faith. Amen. Now, every person here, at one time or another, you had faith. Amen. And the Lord bless you according to your faith. Otherwise, he can only bless you because he gave you a measure of faith. gave you a measure. Now what did you do? Amen. Well, think about that, amen. So everybody had a half a measure of faith. So at one time or another you had a measure. But now he says, praise God, amen. So God dealt to you a measure of faith. Amen. So the faith that you use is going to be your faith. I believe Jesus said to them, and prayed to them, according to your faith, be it unto you. Why? Because that was his faith that made him whole. Woman had issued blood, amen. He said, our faith had made thee whole. It was her faith that made her whole. Amen. Her faith. He said to one man, you believe I can do it? He said, yeah. According to your faith, be it unto you. You see, every time, and praise God. So God gave you faith. Amen. It's going to be your faith that brings deliverance to you. Right?
Amen.
When God told Abraham to come out of the kinfolk and go into a land out of God would show it was his faith that brought him. It was his faith. Amen. I know we sometimes, amen, we say we go, amen, have the faith of Abraham, but it might not be quite like that. You need your faith. So if you don't have faith, ain't nothing gonna happen to you.
That's right.
Can't nothing happen to you.
Amen.
But you can only be blessed by your faith.
Yes. Yes.
You can only be delivered by your faith.
Amen.
You can only be successful is by your faith.
Amen.
Amen. When Daniel, amen, praise God, you know, faith always makes you do something out of the ordinary. Right? And that's why, amen, the scripture said, be not confirmed to will be trampled by the new mind. It's something, amen, that you got to do that sometimes I don't believe you can do it. Huh? Amen. In order to do the impossible, you got to have a new mind. That makes good sense. That makes good sense. Because, amen. I'm going to read it again. Amen. Praise God. Listen to what it says. And be not conformed to this world. Because if you follow this world, the world is going to carry you a whole different way.
Amen.
The Bible said, plainly, no man can serve two masters. He's going to either love one, hate the other, or love one, despise the other one. So, amen, praise God. So you can't have really faith, amen, in God unless you can give up something. You had to lay somebody down. The one thing you had to lay down was what? And the reason you had to lay down the word is because the word is contrary to where you go. The word only tell you and say to you, you can only be have so much and so much. That's all you can have. The word tell you you're limited to so much. You're limited to your paycheck. You're limited to your job. You're limited to this. And that's all you can have. But God's word say you have whatever you say. Whatever you ask for. Amen. So, amen. So that means, amen, that something will happen for you to believe that you can have above and over what, amen, that job say you can have, you're going to have a new mind.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. When Daniel, amen, went to the lion den, like he did something extra. They signed the decree, said, don't you go to the lion den. But he chose rather than go upstairs and raise the one. He said, don't you pray. Don't you pray. Amen. You just, amen. Now, you, if you call everybody else, let me the king. Don't call upon no other God other than the king. Then you went upstairs and raised the one that got on his knees and prayed three times a day to Almighty God.
Amen.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So man said, do one thing. God said, do something else.
Amen.
Amen. So that's what makes it different, right? Amen. I say amen. Praise God. He prayed and heaven will be closed. And God will close the heaven for 3 years and 6 months. And I was thinking about that. Amen. Praise God. I believe that what happened, amen, he's called up to heaven, but it had to be to prove to Ahab that he was God. Why? Because he was out there by the brook drinking water. So he didn't just need it for himself, amen, because amen, he had to prove that he was God, that God could do it. See, a lot of things we don't know God can do. We said, well, I hope he can do it. I pray he can do this. I hope he can. No, but there ain't no hope in God. God can do anything. Amen. 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 The three Hebrew boys went to the fire for him. They did what? Amen. They didn't go just to be gone. They went because they would not drink the cane wine. They would not eat the cane meat. And they put them in the fire for him. And it was their faith that brought deliverance to them. Always remember that their faith that brought deliverance. Amen. And what I'm trying to say here today, and amen, and Jude is saying here, amen, that God dealt to every one of you a measure of faith. Right? That ain't got to be a reason you don't still have faith. Come on, I know you can say praise God. Amen. I said there's got to be a reason you don't still have faith. Huh? The reason, amen, because God dealt to every one of us a measure of faith. And Jude said, amen, honest content for the faith that was delivered to the saints. So that is a faith delivered unto you. Now what did you do? Amen. And you got to think about that, praise God. You want to show you believe in your God? You say you believe in your God. But something had destroyed your faith. Amen. No. Something, amen, caused you not to believe God. Amen. Caused you not to trust God. Was it your neighbor? Was it your friend? Was it your preacher? Who was it? It was something that stole your faith away from you. If it had not stolen it, you still had it. Huh? Something had to take your faith away from you, and you can look at me and say, oh, amen, I still have my faith there. And maybe you do, but what you done with it? Elijah, amen, prayed on the raven, amen, to feed him twice a day, amen, needed bread because he had faith. Amen. You listen to what I'm saying? What are you doing with your faith? Now, if you have faith, are you working? Amen. Come on. James said, faith without work is dead being alone. So if you got dead faith, somebody called it to die. Faith don't just die to be dying. It's somebody, amen, that you were trusting in causing your faith to die. There's somebody you had confidence in calling you to lose your faith. If they had to call you to lose, you should have faith. Right? But amen, what did that happen? Amen. I'm in the read the faith part. He says, hey, I believe it. Maybe I need to read to go back. I need to go back to Rome one more time. Let's read the faith first. Somebody got you away from a holy living. Somebody called you not to believe, amen, not to live a clean life. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the grace of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice. Then living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God when you're your reasonable son. Now, I didn't think we have a lot to do with somebody losing their faith. And be not conformed to this world. Yeah, when you go play by faith, go play by how many words you got. Amen. Go and think about where you're going tonight. Where you spending your time at. Amen. Somebody told me you don't take all that. I'll get you that too. Somebody said you don't have to live right. And this is what happened. Glory, I'm going to make you a lesson. Amen, Jude. Amen. This is the way he said it. I am a God. Amen. The 10 for the faith with one little son. But there are certain men who creep in on the way. Somebody creep in your life on the way. Whether from the pulpit, or from the job, or from somewhere, somebody creep in your life on the way. And when they creep in your life on the way, they destroyed your faith. You're still alive, but you ain't got no faith. Huh? You ain't in the grave, but you still ain't got no faith. Because the same being crept in on the way. Who was before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly. Now, it might be an ungodly preacher behind the pulpit. Now, I'm not talking about y'all preachers, don't get me wrong. Well, you got ungodly preaching. You got dead faith. Huh? And if you got a preacher that didn't bathe and didn't have all that kind of stuff in church, you got dead faith. I'm just going to tell you the truth. And I'm not talking about your preacher. Can you say amen again? Amen. The only way you can ought to have faith in God, you got to have a holy man of God preaching to you. I'm not talking about the church either. I'm not somebody living right.
That's right.
Living clean.
Yeah.
Living holy.
Yeah.
Not ungodly. And this is why I'm trying to say it, because a lot of times that we don't know, amen, the people that we're trusting in is living ungodly.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. People that, amen, that have control of our life and living ungodly.
Yeah.
Amen. Just because you see people shouting, it doesn't mean they're living them. There are a lot of people that ain't living nothing and shouting and talking to each other. That's true. Can you say amen?
Amen.
But amen. So you don't go by that and what you say. For there are certain men crept unaware. When full of days to this condemnation of ungodly men turn the grace of God into lasting. And that's what killed the faith. Amen. What they do, they turn the grace of God. Oh, what it said. You know what it said? It don't take all of it. Anytime people tell you it don't take all of it, they're going to destroy your faith. Because number one, it takes more than this. Huh? Peter said, after we've done the will of God, we ain't just said we also unproper servant, we only done that which I do, didn't do.
Yeah.
So it's gonna take more than we think it takes. Amen. To go to heaven, praise God.
Yeah.
Turn the grace of God. Somebody say, oh my Lord, you can do what you want to do. Huh? You're not amen, praise God. And you know you heard people say, it don't take all that. This is for the old folks. Same hell the old folks going to the young folks going there too. So there ain't going to be no damn hell. So it's going to take as much to keep you in amen, get you into heaven, more than to get me into heaven. You understand what I'm talking about? But he said, it's crammed in the church on the way. Nobody know they were there. It's amazing how people can take hold of your life and tell you, amen, make your life weak and you don't know what they're making. Tell you all the different things you don't have to do.
It's all right.
I had a man telling me what's happening. I was going to save in the world. He said, you know, we don't have to get enough food, alcohol in our food, so we need to drink a little beer. You know the preacher. He tells me I need to drink some beer, get some more alcohol in it. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Now, amen. And praise God. And I can tell you this is not wrong, and that's not wrong, and this is not wrong. And amen. You got so many things not wrong, which is ain't nothing. Come on, come on. Ain't nothing faith. According to the Bible, now look at the Bible, right? Then you had faith. Huh? Paul said God had dealt to every man a measure of faith. So that means every man here have faith. Now what do you do with your faith? Is it working for you? And you get things done and you want them to get done? Are you going, amen, are you getting the blessing of the Lord like you want the blessing of the Lord for your life? Yeah. Amen. So, amen, something has happened, amen, and causing you, amen, be doubtful. The Bible says, Lord, amen, do you remember? At one time he said, you knew this. Now, let me read that word, it's fifth word. I would have walked with you and remembered, though he once knew. So now, that means you had faith in one time, didn't it? He said, and this is what he said, I will therefore put you in remembrance, though he once knew you. How the Lord, having saved the people out of the land of Egypt, and afterward destroyed them that believed not. But at one time, he said, you knew it. Right? No wonder Judas said, God, if you did with faith, no one would be able to say. Because at one time you knew right from wrong. At one time you knew what God could do in your life. You knew, amen, you could believe that God could do just anything. But now, amen, you see the Jews saying, amen, praise God. At one time, the children of Israel knew that God was a living one. And one time, amen, they knew that God could do anything. But now, amen, praise God, he's saying here, glory to God. He went on to say the sixth foot, and the angel which kept not his first estate, but left thy own habitation. He had reserved the everlasting chain under darkness until the day of judgment. Angels that didn't keep death. So even angels, amen, the angels that fell away from God, left God. Amen. They left their faith. They left, amen, the word of God, the commandment of God, and fell away. But he said God never changed until the day of judgment. But he didn't say, one time you knew this. One time you knew right from wrong. One time you knew what God can do. You knew the blessing of the Lord. You knew how great God was. One time you knew, and you actually believed in the ever-working power of the Lord. But somebody told you, now you know what they told you, it ain't for you today. That was for the apostles. That was for people that ain't gone by. Well, God don't perform me for today. He doesn't heal today. He doesn't open the blind eyes of the blind. He doesn't bless. He doesn't heal today. If you said it, amen. Oh my God. He used to heal. He used to work miracles, but the God that I serve is still a different one. The God that I serve is still healing the sick. The God that I serve is still raising the dead. He's still performing miracles. Come on now. I'm talking about the God that I'm serving, and the God that you once knew is still doing the same thing that he was doing then. He hadn't changed. Everything else changed, but God never changed. You know, amen, when you really think about it, he doesn't change. Faith never changed because God never changed. Huh? If God changed, then faith had changed. But God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, so he never changed. The God that you believe in, the God that you trusted, you had to wake up one morning and find out he done changed his mind. Because the Bible said Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. He said, I am the Lord, change now. So you don't have to worry about him changing mind. You had to change your mind. And that would make faith so strong. And it was you said you should only contend for faith because faith don't change. You didn't lost. Huh? You lost your faith. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Even though you might be still in church, but you still be a lost your faith. But somebody done lost the faith. Everywhere Jews say, I'm content for the faith that I want to deliver to you. Otherwise, somebody, amen, he delivered it to you. Now you know delivered me. He walked in there and gave me to me. He delivered me. That wasn't delivered me. See, he delivered him. So if it wasn't no mistake, you got it. You may not know you got it, but you got that thing. Because he had walked in there and delivered to you. This for you, baby. See what I'm talking about? That's why you know every one of us have faith. Because he delivered to us faith at one time or another. God delivered to every one of us a measure of faith. Right? Now, if somebody had to take it from you. Right? And somebody that walked, you don't know what to do. They walked into you and said, take my faith. Now what you got? You ain't got no faith. They took your faith. The devil done took your faith. The devil done stole your faith. And this is why people go to church and don't get nothing, because the devil got the faith, they ain't got nothing. The only way you can believe God, you got to have faith. Huh? The only way that you can believe God, the Bible says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. He that cometh to God must first believe that God is. No one got to believe he is. Now, amen, he says, what he says here, he said, amen, praise God. Ungodly, turn the grace of God into thy sin. Right? So you lost your faith when you went somewhere you had no way to go. Oh, go y'all with me. You know, one church said, remember your faith there. Remember why you lost to that. Go back to get up again. So that first love, when you lost, you know why you lost that. Every one of us would know. You know why you lost out of God. You know why you got in touch with God. That make good sense? It's not a problem. We can't say that again. But just remember that God, amen, is not with you. Unless you like Samson. Samson thought that God was still with him. He went out and shook himself just like he had been doing. Not knowing that God had left him. Had departed from him. And this is what's happening, amen, in our church world today. Is because, amen, we don't realize that what you have if you don't continually live holy. You lose it. You see what I'm talking about? Yeah. If you want to, amen, if you want more of God, you got to continue. And like he said, I will send you that more, brother, by the mercy of God, you present your body a living sacrifice. Yeah. You got to give up something. Yeah. You know, in the basement, that want all God got, but how much are you willing to give up? Yeah. To get what all good God got. Yeah. Right? So you got to give up something to get something. Right? That make your sin. He said, amen. Within your body and live in sack. Otherwise, not dead. Don't wait to die. Somebody put you on the altar. Get on the altar now. You want to bless. You want to be have great faith. Make it a sin like Daniel did. Amen. And he's going to call them on his God. Make glory to God. Make it a sin like the Hebrew boys said. We ain't going to eat the cane meat and we ain't going to drink the cane wine. Hallelujah. No, okay, he said, you're going to the fire plant. He said, who is that God that will deliver you? He said, our God is able to deliver us. And our God will deliver us. And we didn't know unto thee, okay, if not, we will not buy. Hallelujah. That's what you call faith, can you say, amen? That's what you call the kind of faith that they had, amen. What did he do? Faith has always come out victorious. Right? Came throwing down the bottom of the pit, amen, and praise God with the clothes on and everything on. Amen, I'm going to bun you up. Amen. He looked again inside and he looked again in the same fun. And he went back to his council and said, how many did we throw in there? Okay, we put three in. He said, behold, I see four. I see one look like the Son of God. He's walking around in the fireplace. Glory to God. Jesus was in the fireplace. brought him out and said, well, I'm going to give them out of the fire. And we're going to see. They make sure. They smelled the hair when the hair was wet. They couldn't even smell the smoke on the clothes. Oh, no. Nobody can deliver like my God. Nobody can bless like my God. Nobody can bring victory to you like God. Can you say, I don't care what you're going through, God can bring it out if you have faith. I don't care how impossible it looks, if you have faith in your God, he will deliver you. Amen. Yeah, people say, well, no, he ain't gonna deliver you, amen. The day of miracle is over. Well, that may be you, but he's still here for me. I'm still believing God can. I'm still believing God in the miracle work. I believe that God is still blessing. I believe that God is still making a way out of no way. Come on, I say, I believe God is still opening doors. But man cannot open, man cannot shut. Glory to God, the man, I opened the open for you, the man cannot shut because he has a little strength. So everything that God has, amen, especially for you, especially for you. Everything that, amen, everybody said you can have it. Can you say amen? Sometimes, amen, to get the best from God. Y'all listen. You might have to give your best friend up. You might have to give your best preacher to get what you want from God. You see what I'm talking about? You may have to give up something. Sometimes you have to give up something to get everything you want from the Lord. How many know it's true? Can you say amen? Sometimes you can't get everything you want. Hold on to everything you got. Sometimes you have to give up something. So you give up something you love. Sometimes you just run to something. Can you say amen? How many know that's true? You believe that? Stand to your feet, praise God. I'll take you, amen. God love us, and amen. I pray you got somebody to listen today. Amen. How many about faith? Every one of us here. Can't go, you can't make this journey without faith. Always remember that this faith is a faith journey. Every step of the way is faith. Faith. Can you say amen? Bring your enjoying hand with someone today. Amen. Believe in God, because God heals the same on yesterday and then today. He hadn't changed. He ain't going nowhere. Amen. We're going to pray for you and pray for you around the world at the same time. Father God, every person that's here today, we ask you the strength force you have. Touch them and bless them. Make them whole and set them free. In every way, oh God. Oh God, let this day be a blessed day to your people. Bless them on every hand. Bless them on every side. Oh God, do something special in the life of your children. And we'll give you glory. And we'll give you praise. Come on, just lift your hand up and give God some thanks. Give me some thanks. Come on. Give the Lord some thanks. Thank you because he's good to you. Have the Lord been good to you? Have the Lord been good to you? Come on, I say, have the Lord been good to you? Come on, I say, have the Lord been really good to you? Come on, you ought to be able to thank him for that goodness. Thank you for letting the time to pass over you. Thank you for giving you health and strength today. Thank you for the middle of your power. Thank you for your blessing. Come on, give the Lord some thanks. Give him some thanks. Give him some thanks. Oh, God. We love you. We love you. Yeah, yeah. You may have your seat if you possibly can. Amen. Have a great time outside today. Amen. Let us receive the offering. Amen. God love a cheerful giver. Let the Lord talk to you, speak to you, and give it. Can you say amen again? Amen. Amen. Praise God. Lord, bless them when they give you this offering today. Bless them one by one, name by name, and they bring the offering. Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God is my
thank you.